29-year-old Simran Chowdhury is one of Britain's wealthiest women.
These are a piece of art. I bought them quite recently, actually. These are by Alexander McQueen.
She has a huge team of staff, including chauffeurs, bodyguards, cleaners, maids, a PA, chefs, and a butler, tending her every need.
And relax.
This highly protected millionaire has never had to learn some of life's more basic skills, such as cooking and cleaning.
I don't think we've ever been home alone.
7 months pregnant, Simran will pose as a first-time mom, taking part in a new television series. Using this cover, she'll throw herself into the heart of the community. But this heiress to a billion-pound fortune will not be going alone. She'll have a highly trained 24-hour security team watching her every move, ensuring not only her safety, but that of her unborn child.
It's like being out in the 80s, love.
At the end of her time undercover, she'll give away life-changing amounts of money.
Do you know anybody with £1.5 million?
I wish.
But the next 8 days will be the biggest challenge she's faced, as she's leaving behind everything she knows whilst heavily pregnant.
Everything about my life is different at the moment. And I was just thinking, is this worth it? I know I'm doing this for a good cause, but God forbid something were to go wrong, I'd never forgive myself.
Okay, Simran, this is a boy because we have seen the testicles and the genitalia.
This is now the female bone. This is the thigh bone.
29-year-old Simran Chowdhury is 7 months pregnant with her and husband Banu's first child.
Sometimes I do get a little nervous thinking, oh, my God, I'm not going to have any freedom and life's just going to change and, you know, it's no longer about me. But most of the time, it's most exciting.
Simran's son will be born into a life of extreme luxury.
Hello.
Descended from Indian royalty and the daughter of a self-made billionaire, Simran is the heiress to a vast family fortune. At 21, she married her childhood sweetheart, Banu, also from a billionaire dynasty.
I ordered 10,000 red roses and filled her whole room up with them. And when she came back, I proposed.
So this is one of the queens.
Despite not having to work, Simran has her own interior design business.
So yes, we add this to the inventory. Yes, please.
She's used her artistic flair to amass a priceless collection of original works of art, from Picasso's to the most iconic of Warhol's.
This room is very, very me. And I think it speaks volumes about Banu and me as well. You know, everything has meaning to us. For example, the mouse, the Damien Hirst. This little guy is another one that I really love. There's this one day in the year, Indian women, they fast because they believe that by sacrificing all this food in the day, it's going to give their husbands a long life. I did that for him. And 2 weeks later, I came home and I found this in the corner and he was like, that's my thank you present. I just thank my lucky stars. I just want to say thank you to the universe for having this come my way. It's that same feeling of I have to give back to society. I have so much. And if I don't share the abundance, it doesn't work.
Born into extreme wealth, Simran's life has always been one of extreme privilege and protection.
I don't even know how I've managed to convince Banu into letting me do this.
Her husband, Banu, has plans to keep his wife safe.
When I found out that Banu had arranged this security, I was definitely a little annoyed because I felt the experience wouldn't be as authentic. But I won't see them physically, so it's fine. I still believe I'm on my own. Okay, so let's say like 10 minutes, because we're just going to start the drinks now.
Even her circle of millionaire friends are concerned about how Simran will cope with life on her own.
Cheers to you, Simran. Cheers. You're going to miss all this champagne, some manicures, pedicures, her hair.
Her maid.
But you have to, if you're going on the train and...
Not first class, is it? The proper Gandhi class.
Are you going to drink tap water? Or are you going to buy mineral water?
Ooh, that's a nice one.
What are you gonna do?
I'll get water.
I'll get water. From where?
I'll economize other places.
So cheers, Simran.
Cheers, Simran. Cheers.
Enjoy yourself, and we'll see you after 8 days.
Cheers,
Simran.
Simran.
Yeah.
Good journey. Wish you all the best.
Yeah.
Come back,
little kids. Otherwise, we'll move.
This morning, I'm feeling a little bit anxious as to how this is going to go. Being out of my comfort zone. I'm going to have to put my people-charming skills into play now, and I hope they haven't gone rusty because of all the protection I've always had. Thank you. What I'm afraid is that people may not open up to me. You know, they might be reserved.
Love you.
Love you too. I have seen plenty of poverty in India because we spent a lot of time when we were younger with staff. We'd venture out into areas which mommy and daddy wouldn't necessarily take us. And when I go and meet my grandmother, they actually own a couple of villages. So we'd play with the village kids, see their mud homes, etc. But I live in England. England is my home, and there is a great deal of suffering over here as well. And I think it would just be wrong to sit back and think, okay, this is a developed nation, doesn't need my help.
Simran's father, a self-made billionaire, made his money from aluminium and steel. Simran is heading to what was once the heart of Britain's steel industry.
At 12:37, then through Sheffield, final destination at 12:52.
Simran will be living in Burngreave, one of the poorest wards in the country. Once the heart of Britain's steel industry, the area is also home to immigrants from around the globe. But although immigration is high, so is unemployment, and one in three households live on benefits.
Whereabouts in Burngreave did you say you want to be, love?
Scott Road.
Bad side of town.
Why?
Why?
Yes.
It's like Beirut in the 80s, love.
Can you be a little positive? It's my new home.
It's your home, love. There's no really positive to say.
Oh, my gosh.
A mate of mine got kidnapped off Barnsley Road for a ransom. And he got tortured as well.
What do you mean by tortured?
They were electrocuting him, beating him up with hammers.
But for what?
To get money out of his family. They thought he was somebody else.
Is there anything good about the area?
Not really, love.
We're here, number 27. It smells all right. It's sinking in that I have to live in this. I'm not just inspecting it. It's going to be home to me. Let's see how I cope with that.
As Simran settles into her new home, her round-the-clock security team are keeping a watchful eye.
I'm worried because I am living on my own in a not very safe area. I wasn't too keen on this security team coming, and I was pushed into it by Banu, and initially I was almost a little bit cross about it. But now I'm glad that they're here, so thank you, Banu. Please, may I have one portion of chips to go?
Pregnant Simran Chowdhury is one of the UK's wealthiest women. She's given up her lavish lifestyle, and for the next 8 days, she'll be living undercover in Burngreave, Sheffield. While Simran is here, she'll look for and be introduced to people who may need her help, using the cover story of taking part in a series about first-time mums.
Yo, you're not a fed, are you?
No, we're not. It's a program called Mum's the World. I'm pregnant, so it's on pregnant women.
Yeah.
I've just moved into Sheffield.
if you're not from area and you're looking in, I suppose it does look like a bit of a shithole, but for people like us who have grown up around here, it's home, you know?
Born in India, but coming to the UK as a pupil at one of the world's most prestigious boarding schools, Simran's experience of immigration is very different from most of those that come to Burngreave, many arriving as refugees or asylum seekers.
It looks like it's in a bad condition. I don't know if I should say that out loud, but it could do with help, definitely. Hi. I'm on a program called Mum's the Word. Is it okay if I get the camera crew in? I'm actually looking to do some voluntary work.
I think there's the second shop across the road, what the charity shop.
Which is also on this street?
On the street, yeah.
Okay. Mum's the Word, yeah?
Mum's the Word. Because I'm pregnant, so yeah. It's for pregnant mothers.
Okay, all right, then, take care, yeah?
Hello.
Hiya.
Sorry, please carry on. Is this a charity shop?
It is a charity shop, yeah.
I'm actually in a programme called Mum's the Word.
Oh,
I'm
right.
I'm a pregnant mother and...
congratulations.
Thank you. And I was looking to do some voluntary work.
Yeah, we're always looking for volunteers.
Started by Yvonne Hayes, Rainbow's End is not merely a charity shop. For many of the refugees and asylum seekers who volunteer here, it provides their only opportunity to work, and offers a vital safe space to anyone in need.
We always say about this shop, you don't have to go to World to see it. World comes here.
Would you say you've had much trouble down this area?
No, there's been... Burngreave has had its sorrows, but Burngreave people bounce back. We get together and we talk about it. We usually have a box of tissues on here. Yeah, Fergus, you moved to Sheffield, didn't you?
Yes. I come from Iraq.
OK. Mm. And how long have you been in the UK?
Nearly now 2 years. That's 1 month or something.
Do you like it?
Yes.
Do you miss home?
Yes, too much.
You can be kind of isolated, but I came in here, met a lot of new friends, got to know a little bit more about Sheffield, so it's not so bad.
So I'm going to see you tomorrow. I'm very excited, and I guess once I get some time in there to talk to each one of them, one by one, I'll get a better idea of the work they do, what kind of help they need, etc. So at least we have a starting point.
Simran's been told about a day centre, which helps some of the more vulnerable members of the community.
I'm on the website for St Wilfred's. They seem to do some good community work.
Hello, good morning.
Good morning. I have just moved into the area, and I'm a pregnant mother, and I was wondering, I believe that you run some women's groups, etc., and I was wondering...
We have many things on. In fact, today we're running a cooking course. Well, you would be very welcome to come down.
OK, great, yes. I'm doing a programme for Channel 4. It's called Mum's the Word.
Oh, right,
so
okay.
I'm going to have a camera crew with me. Would that be all right if they came in?
OK, yes, it would.
Hello.
Hello. Hello.
Hi. Are you Kevin?
How are you? I am Kevin.
Kevin,
who
I'm Simi. I spoke with you this morning.
Right, you're very, very welcome. How
thank
are you?
Thank you. I'm good,
you're
thank
cold,
you.
Cold, very
I'm cold.
Cold. Just follow me, Simi, please.
Kevin Bradley runs St Wilfred's, a centre that caters for over 100 clients a day.
Who are the clients?
The clients can be people that are homeless, people literally that are sleeping on the streets turn up at the door. But also we have people with mental health problems, people with learning difficulties, and they all mix together. And I think we've found the secret, because sometimes a lot of the people that come to us have never had a chance in life. But here we respect each other, and that's why the atmosphere is so nice. This is where the cooking class, we call this...
Like the rest of the centre, St Wilfred's Ladies Group aims to build confidence in its clients and caters for those with a wide variety of problems, from abused women to those with learning difficulties.